Hello all. I've got a 36 foot Hunter Cherubini here, 1980 model. It's on the water. I've taken it sailing. I'll attach a video for the short sail I did a little while ago in it. And I'm going to take you on a walk around now, show you the boat. From the outside you can see it's red. That's a fresh paint job on it with the yellow boot stripe also done as well. Alright, let's go approach the boat and have a look at it. Before we get on board, you'll note that it has a sad looking sun cover on the furled head sail. The head sail itself is good, but the sun cover itself is showing signs of wear. I do have the new canvas sitting below decks in a roll to go with the boat. So if you're feeling like you're up for a sewing job, you can sew on a new sun cover on the head sail. The mainsail itself under that cover is Kevlar. It's not a canvas sail or a plastic sail, it's a Kevlar sail. The sail is in good condition except for one spot on it that has a 4-inch round wear hole in it on the trailing edge of the sail when you open it up. Other than that, it just needs a little bit of a clean and it's good to go. I've sailed with that head sail as it is and it works perfectly fine. The bimini top is a different color. No holes, no tears. Probably do with a little bit of waterproofing. Other than that, it's doing its job. Okay, the boat's name is Whisper. And we're now going to step on board and have a look at the boat proper. We'll note that the cockpit area is nice and clean. The a lot of the varnishing has been done. As you can see there, looks good. We'll have a look in the aft lazarette. See what we've got in here. We've got a transformer there for the 110 to 12 volt system. On the other side there is the fridge compressor. You can't really see that, can you? Hang on. There we go. The light of the sun is causing this phone to automatically darken and such. So yeah, there's the compressor. The compressor is not connected up, I found. Not sure why. But then again, a lot of stuff that was not connected up in this boat. And when I did connect stuff up, it all worked perfectly fine. So I can't say why. The compass is in nice condition. It's got no bubble in it, so there's no leaking of fluids. The electronics are down in the navigation table. Electronics fit on here, so that's there as well. One's a Hummingbird and the other one's a not sure what you call that. We'll have a look at it when we get down there. Now the other lazarette we have down here, we have some batteries. This is two of the five batteries on board the boat. If we look further down in here, you'll notice there's more batteries going underneath the boat there. So there's three more batteries under there. Five batteries in total. This here is the propane tank in a plastic case for running the propane. I don't know if the propane works. I don't like propane. I had one blow up in my face one time, so I've never touched it. Over here we've got a hot water tank. It's been disconnected via the hose. I'm going to say that this water tank doesn't work because it probably needs a new thermostat or a heating element. It does hold water though. The reason I say that is because when I turn the power on through the 110 volt system to the water heater, I get a open circuit warning. So there's a shortness in that either the thermostat or the heater element. Down there you'll see the battery charger, ProSport T20, oh, ProSport 20 I should say, It's currently on. You can probably see, I don't know if you can see the blue light on there or not. It's right there on the right hand corner. It's very faint. But yep, it's keeping the batteries charged. If we look down there, we'll see this, the other end of the third battery sticking out there. And numerous other bits of wiring and such in this lazarette. Alright, the depth sounder, which is this one here, it works. We'll turn it on a little bit and we'll have a look at that. And that one there is the speed. The speed doesn't show for some reason. It may be a stuck wheel. I'd have to go in the water and check. I can't imagine there's anything major wrong with it. I do believe it does come on. What else can I show you right up here before I go downstairs? Okay, here we have an AC unit. It operates. We'll have a look at that in a sec as well. You'll notice the handrails on both sides have been re-varnished, so they're done. On the bow is the windlass. It's got an electric windlass in place for the anchor. That windlass, again, I've tested the power using a multimeter. There's no power going to the windlass from the engine room, so I'd have to check to find out what's where the lack of power is from. All right, so what else can I show you up here? I think that's pretty much it. The decks themselves are hard. They don't have any soft spots on either side. I've walked around this entire boat along the top over here as well. It's a little bit dirty, but other than that, they're good and solid. The solar vent is working, currently working right now. All right, I'm gonna go downstairs and I'll turn this video back on. So here we go into the boat, down the stairs. And to the left, we have the galley. Galley has got storage here, storage there. I wonder if we can do something about that sunlight coming in. Make it easier for the camera. Not a little bit, not a lot. But yeah, so we've got storage area in there, quite large. And we got storage in there as well, some sliding doors. We got some drawers in the back here. And these drawers here. This is the fridge freezer area in here. It's a little bit musty, needs a bit of a clean. And yeah, so there's that as well. This is the gas cooktop, two cooktops there. I haven't ever used it because I don't like gas, because one blew up in my face one time and I won't touch them anymore. So there's that. We've got the kitchen sink here, and we've got storage underneath the kitchen sink, a little bit down there. We've got a bin here, opens up, there's the bin. That's the that's the galley. On the other side, we've got the navigation table. Got some storage underneath, some bits and pieces in there. And we've got a little drawer in here for stuff as well. And we've got a little cupboard up here above the two-way radio, which you can see is showing on. It's got 16. What is that? This is a little light there. That strip is a light that's lost its double-sided stickiness, has come off. So we've also got the 110 amp. That's your shore power panel right there. As you can see, the needle is on, showing the shore power is on. The gauge to the right shows the amount of draw right now, which is virtually zero. Then you have the 12 volt panel here, which is also on, showing you some lights on of the things I've turned on. And we've got a radio here as well. The radio works. The speakers aren't the best. They've probably been used too much. Got a little bell here as well. Ceiling is solid fiberglass and is clean. somebody decided to stick those night glow stickers on the ceiling here. They've left a couple of little spots there. They can be taken off. There you'll see the AC unit. AC unit works. Let's turn it on. Okay, how about we turn the power to the power points on first? Then we can. I'm not sure which ones it is, so I'm just going to turn them all on. Now, there we go. You can hear the fan going. Air start to come out. Right now it's a bit warm. The filters probably need a bit of cleaning. And it's working, it's working. It's just starting to go cool now. Okay, so a little bit slow getting cool, but it's getting there. Okay, so, oh, wait a minute. Oh, yep, that's off. This fan here in these, let's see if we can get this to go on as well. Da-da-da-da-da. Well, what have we got going on here? We got a circuit breaker. That's what it was. Wrong circuit breaker. It was turned on. There we go. Fan just turned on. There you have it. Yay, that works. So this is the saloon area. We've got seating here on the starboard side. And we've got storage underneath. Bit of storage there. We've got storage under here as well. Big area of storage underneath there. And then it's, you also have the same setup over that side too. Underneath here is the water tank, which is empty. You got some shelving there, some stuff is stored. Behind the seats you've got storage as well. And a bit more there. Then you've got cupboard space in here as well. So you have that. That's on the starboard side. On the port side, we have a microwave. You'll notice the light is on the microwave. The microwave works. Drawers. Underneath, we've got more storage space there and there. There is another water tank underneath the seating here, which is also empty. And you've got storage behind as well. As you can see, there's some cookware and such there. Some containers of spare parts. And the mounts for the rigging. Okay, oh yes, and there's a TV here as well. So all that is in the saloon. Here we have, walking from here, we walk forward in the boat, and we've got cupboards. We've got a closet here for hanging stuff in. A couple of clear plastic covers for the cockpit entranceway. Couple of boards that were used for who knows what. They were there when I bought the boat, so they go with it. And turning around, we have the head. It has a shower, and it has this there's the toilet, which is a manual pump toilet. It works. We're missing one door here, but there's more shelving underneath. That door's still there. Then we've got underneath here, we have a waste bin, and we have storage in here as well, and in there as too. So then we have into the V berth, more drawers, storage underneath, is a little vacuum cleaner there, more storage there as well. In that back area there is a toaster oven. In here there's a couple of fans and a heater in that area. They go with the boat. Shelving inside the V berth. We have the windlass control here for the windlass on the bow. As you can hear it, that's running. So that works. You can actually take that out onto the bow of the boat because the cable is long enough to do that, as you can see, through the cockpit hatch area. So there's that. Now we go back this way. Oops. Turn around from the V berth. We're looking back into the main interior of the boat. Oh, wait a minute. I'll show you the ceiling as well. Ceiling's nice and clean here. See if I can block out some of the glare. Ceiling's nice and clean. There we go. Again, solid fiberglass ceiling, no panels to fall down on your head. This has got a door here for the head. That's there as well. All right. The water pump for the water is going to turn it on temporarily because there's no water in the system, but you'll hear it running. I think you can hear that. That's the water pump running. So there's that as well. What else can I show you? I think that's pretty much else. Pretty much all of it for the interior. Yeah, and we're good to go. You've seen the exterior of the boat. We did a walk around up there. You heard the engine running, so that's good. Everything's operational. I'm attaching a video at the end of this one of a couple of minutes of us sailing this boat a little while ago. And so enjoy. All right. What else can I tell you? Oh, yes, this is the table. It comes off these hooks, slips into that slot there. There's a pin you'll see right there. And that holds the table while it's in the horizontal position. So there's an outdoor table here for you for when you're entertaining and eating and such. Okay, I'll call that a day. Bye-bye. Here we are on the Hunter 36. We're out on the Pamlico River. We've got some good wind going. I have no head sail, but the mainsail is up. It looks rather ugly, but it's a Kevlar sail, so very lightweight. And we're getting about 4.5 knots at the moment with just the mainsail up. We're rocking a bit. We've got white caps on the water. It's looking very cool. Now I'm going to introduce everyone. I'm going to say their name as I pan around. Hello.
Stephanie.
Hello, Stephanie.
Hi.
And we have over here her husband.
Bly.
Christopher.
So, yep, we're out testing the boat, seeing if we sink. So, we're doing quite well. The navionics, this just doesn't turn on at all. It's not working. This one works, but it's got a bad screen on it, so. You can read the screen still, it's a hummingbird. It's doing its job, it's giving us the depth, and it's giving us a nice view of what's under the boat. And the wind is nice and strong, I would say 15 knots minimum, gusting up to 20-25. We've got a nice little feeling going on the boat, it's not very extreme. It's turning out to be quite a pleasant afternoon. So, that's it for now. I will make another video on the way back. Talk to you soon.